Association scheme and have only one non-principal representation. We know that such scheme doesn't exist by him and Syria, but if it would exist, it could have all multiplicities of the same. Well, there would be just one multiplicity, but imagine that you have several irreducible representations and all of them have the same multiplicity, then the theorem says, well, then all the analysis should be equal, the scheme should be commutative, and all the sequence values should be the same. So let me show the proof. So we start with this with the fact. We look at the frame number, and we have all multiplicity the same. Let's call this common multiplicity by n, right? So what do we have here? We have n to the power n1 squared plus n1 squared, right? And here we have the derivative. Now, but what if the sum of the squares, sum of all squares, including principal representation, is the dimension of the algebra, that means d plus 1, but here we don't have the principal one, so the whole sum is d, right? So, we get this, that this number is integer. Now, let's go further. We have another equation which says if we take every representation, take its degree, multiply by multiplicity, and add them up. So, let me write down that the standard character is a linear standard. Now, if I plug in the identity here, then I will get the number of points is equal to the sum mi from 0 to L, but for 0 this is 1, and then I have a sum starting from 1, right? And all mi's are equal to this n. So here, what I get from here, that omega is co-prime to n. So that omega is co-prime to n. But if it is co-prime to n, then this number is an integer, right? Then this should be an integer. So this implies that K1, KD, MD, and D is an integer. Because this thing, right, is co-prime. So this number should be like this. Now, if you look at the balances, the sum of all balances without the identity, what it is? It's omega minus 1. So now I use the well-known inequality between the geometric mean and the arithmetic mean. It says if I take the d through to the curve, right, and it's less or equal than k1 up to k divided by d, right? So, what is this sum? It's omega minus 1 divided by g. So if I, what is omega minus 1 divided by d, if you, let's, we have one expression for this, like that, but, So now, this implies that k1 times kd is less or equal than, than this number, sum of ki from 1 to l. Yeah, divided by b to the power of b. Right. Is it correct? Is it correct? Yeah. So, yeah. Now, so, now let's continue. We have this number, and this number is an integer, so it should be at least 1. So it's 1 less or equal k1 kd, m to the d, and it's less or equal than. So we will get from here that all k1 should be equal to that. Okay. So in this case, we have. So if all velocities are the same, then all If all of the pieces are the same, then all else is the same. The converse is not true. And there are there is a strong radiography from not mistaken on 21 points. This radiograph. So it has the same velocity, so 10-10, but the multiplicity is not. Now I'm going to prove a Michael-Wallace theorem that an association scheme applies over a period of units. So the special interest is that, well, if you think about analogy between loop theory and association schemes, that we know what are the groups for the P. These are the cyclic groups. But if we think about the association schemes for P, well, we know that there are more than one, and there are some which comes from a group which is Schurter scheme. What you do, you take a subgroup. Take a subgroup of the Christian group, and you consider the secondary product, which acts on ZP as a final summation. The scheme of the orbits of this group, and scheme of the orbits of this group is commutative. All velocities and non multiplicities are the same, so they are equal to the order of the range. For example, if it is order p minus 1 divided by 2, we get a scheme of n. So these are Schurter. Now, what about no Schurter? Well, the only known no Schurter things of order p come from a skew Hadamard matrices. There is a construction which is drawn by a skew Hadamard matrix of order p plus 1, not order p plus 1. So it comes from skew Hadamard matrices of order p plus 1. And all of them have rank 3, so we don't know any non-Schurter association scheme of prime order which is not more than 3. So that's actually the one question. Rather, at least. And now I'm going to prove Michaelis theorem. So the original proof of Michaelis used monologue corrective theory, but then it was adapted. And several times, and I call this limitation is correct. Yes, so we'll change that. So we start with the lemma. So it says, now let F be an arbitrary field, and the other matrix, and the property is that the trace of any power of this matrix is zero. Okay? So then, if the characteristic is zero, then zero is the only multiplicity of that. Yes, it's important. In children form with zeros. But if characteristic is bigger than zero, then every non-zero eigenvector is multiplicity is applied to characteristic. So that means that characteristic or minimum polynomial of that matrix is a form x to some power, and some polynomial, f to the power of P, but P is characteristic of P. Okay, let me prove this. You can always take the closure of your field, so you can assume that all eigenvalues of your matrix are inside the field. So let's call them lambda 1, 1, n. Okay. The eigenvalues, I count every eigenvalue. Well, there may be the same eigenvalue. So, and now what I have is that the sum of lambda I is the case power from 1 to n, is 0 for any k starting from any k is natural number. Well, first you may now forget about the matrix, you can think just about sequence. Scalars, maybe not necessarily different, which have the same property. And now you can remove all zeros, so they don't matter, right? So you can remove zeros. Now we may assume that here we have only non zeros. And now we can say, assume you have lambda 1, n1 times lambda 2, n2 times. And lambda k and k times, where all lambda i's are pairwise distant. Pairwise distant. Well, now here is k. That's not, let's call it. So now if you look at this is the proof to write sum from one to L and I lambda R to the K is 0. But now these lambdas are different. Now if you build a matrix, you will see that there is another matrix which has no zero determinant. That means all these coefficients should be zero in your field, right? So if field is characteristic zero, then all of them should be zeros. And if the field has characteristic p, then they should be divisible by p. And this proves the lemma. Okay, now is the lemma, which is based on this linear algebra fact, and which says assume you have an association scheme of p points, then its characteristic polynomial, if you take the polynomial p, is congruent to this polynomial. Right. So, the second is that for any rational character, the second, so rational means you have a representation with a rational character. Right. So it's a rational integer. We have these components. Now the first step, let me take the adjacency matrix A, adjacency matrix O S. Now every adjacency matrix in association C is walk regular. What does it mean walk regular? If I take A to K power, it is a linear combination of basic matrices, right? So, and the identity matrix is contained in some integer coefficients, and here are non-identical matrices. Now take the trace of this matrix, right? So the trace of this matrix is lambda k times p, but if we draw in the field of characteristic p, so it's zero in the p. So now I can use the lemma. The lemma says that in this case the minimal polynomial should have the form it should be of what? Well, or you can say that every eigenvalue should be either zero or at least p at least. Now the matrix A has one eigenvalue. This is eigenvalue Kx. So how many eigenvalues do we have? We have k minus 1, right? So we cannot have now eigenvalues of multiples of p if they are not equal to this one, right? So if the rest are zeros for the p, right? Then look at this eigenvalue, it's multiplicity, if it's not zero, but if it is zero, then everything is zero modulo p and we are done. But if it's not zero modulo p, right, then its multiplicity should be p, and we have that all eigenvalues here, equal to ks, and this is exactly the what we are claiming here. So was it correct? Okay. Good. Well, I'm presenting this for the first time, right? And it's different from what it was. Well, this lemma was designed by Kamaki from a lecture course given by Ilya and Maria. Yeah, but the rest is also different. So now, if you take a rational character, what is a rational character? Theta of S. It's a sum of some algebraically conjugated characters. Theta and K. So they are permitted by Gauss. Every one of them is the sum of algebraic numbers. So if I go down to the algebraic numbers, I will get here the algebraic numbers, the sum of algebraic numbers, which are permitted by Gauss group. And how many algebraic numbers I will get here? Well, this is exactly the multiplicity of theta 1 times k. So this will be degree of theta. So this is the sum of theta 1 algebraic numbers. And this is the rational integer. Now, if you go back to polynomials, you know that your polynomial should be congruent to this one. So this sum, it's an integer, it should be congruent to this value. And that's what we need for the rest of the proof. So this is how we avoid the modulo. Now, here's the proof. Okay. Well, let's take the standard basis of limited and the others. Now, let's take, we have some number of characters. We have some number of reducible characters.
Do you have a principal now?
And we have some number of reducible characters, and the yellow group can reduce it. So my goal is to prove that it extracts the zero of them. So then you can say, well, it extracts the zero of them, they should have the same multiplicity, right? Then we can use the previous result, which says if it's the same multiplicity, then it should be commutative, right? But actually, we can get a direct proof, which says, okay, let's set up the sum. Well, I take some irreducible character, and I take all Galois conjugates of this character. So how many of them? Well, I don't know how many of them is. So 1 plus Lewis not S, okay, to the S. And this is the rational character. So because this rational character is relative on every basic matrix, it should be a rational integer. On the other hand, we know that theta S is congruent. Set of 1 times ks over p. Right. So that means we can write this rational integer in this way, where this ui is an integer. It could be negative, positive. Now, you know that for this one, we have k0 is 1, and u0 is 0. Oh, yeah, not for the principle, for the identity. Now, if you remember that the similarity relation says if you take any irreducible character which is not principal, then it sums on all elements of your scheme is 0, right? So this theta, it does not contain the principal one because it's an orbital double group.
So r minus 1 is d.
Yes. Very good. R minus 1 is d. It's correct. Yeah. And this scheme with d plus is a frank r. Okay. So now, so we know that the eigenvalue should be integer of that type. Okay. Now I have a similarity relation, so I take the sigma theta 1 ki minus uip, and this should be 0, right? I from 0 to r. Okay, not d. So it should be 0. Now, if you sum of ki's, sum of ki's is p, right? So you get, then it comes up by p, because theta 1 is the sum of ui's. So theta y is the sum of ui's. Now, if you look at the if you look at the matrix ki, then because our scheme is primitive, that means the principal eigenvalue of the ki against multiplicity 1 doesn't appear. So and all others. Eigenvalues are less by absolute value than ki. So what does it say about this character? So it's less by absolute value than theta 1 times ki. And if it's less than this number, but on the other hand it's this number, so the ui is bigger than 0. So that means that ui is equal to the integer. So therefore, we get that theta 1 is u1 up to ur minus 1. So theta 1 is at least r minus 1. Now, Now, if it is the sum of parallel conjugate characters, as they go here, so therefore it really specifies degree of the set of one. So what we have now, we have now that this number, the derivative of the R minus one, and what is the R minus one? R minus one is the sum of squares, right? And this sum of squares, so well, we have S characters of the same dimension, so we have this inequality. Therefore, 10 minus 1 is 1, and as that from this inequality following, S should be equal R minus 1. So that means that we have R minus 1 irreducible characters which are one dimensional. So this can be commutative. And so, and this proves the theorem. But an open question is whether it is algebraically isomorphic to be sure anyone. So if it is commutative, then the theorem of Kanagi-Kuna implies more. First it says that Galois group X transitive characters. Second, it says that all multiplicities should be the same, right? Because they are color conjugate. And as we have shown before, in this case, all balances are equal to the multiplicity, so there is a certain number. So we have certain number, well, we have D times K, D relations of balance K, and we have D, well, non-identical relations, and D non-principal multiplicity of K. So if you remember the train ratio, this fraction will be equal to 1. So what is left is just a number of points, which is P, to the variable K. Now, so this implies that K divides P minus 1. So in the same situation as we had in the Turing case itself. Now, assume I take a Schurian spin with the same parameter of K. So I take a sample for a K, do the Schurian spin. Is it true that they have the same structure constants? Well, we don't know the answer. So we know it's true if D is true. Well, and it can be true if D is 3, then it also be the same, but I don't know about it. More. Also, it was proven by Ilya Komarenko and Don Chiang that if K is less some constant times cubic power of P, then the scheme is Schurian. And if it's Schurian, we know what it is. So this is all we know about the scheme of time order. So I finished my lecture for thank you for the patience. Patience is it's not truth. Yeah.
Are there many known examples where a complete graph can be divided into three strongly regular
graphs? Well, there are many examples I can. Well, of course, it depends on the parameters. If you don't care about parameters of strongly regular graphs, you can build a lot of examples in the following way. Every affine plane, if you have a fine plane from the end, a fine plane of all the areas. So it gives an association scheme of all the n square with n plus 1 plus 6. And classes are 1 to 1 correspondence with classes of parallel lines. That means red is n plus 2. So you have S0, S1, Sn plus 1. All relations are symmetric, all relations are disconnected. And the property is you can fuse this relation as you want, and you will, and this fusion will get to the association scheme, right? So you can take partition into three parts. Then it will be an association scheme, and every fusion here will be stronger as the right. Okay? So you will have quite a little an expansion on that. In the end.
Since we have some time, would you mind explaining the circular dilemma again?
Which one?
Something when you were explaining the Milton matrix. So yes, this one, the first.
The propositional dilemma.
Dilemma, first point of the dilemma.
Oh, the first point of the dilemma. Okay. You have the characteristic polynomial, right? And what happens if you take the matrix?
Sorry, the second
point. Oh, the second point. Okay. Well, now, the second one. So theta S is the sum of algebraic integers lambda, let's call it M, where M is the dimension of the representation, right? And this is an integral number. Now, if you take the polynomial for S, right, then in that polynomial you will get the vector, this vector, right? You will get this vector, and but this is polynomial with integral coefficients, because Galois group removed this root, so it has integral coefficients. So you can compare the modulo E, and the modulo E is x minus ks to power m, right? Why? Because the characteristic polynomial is that, and this should divide the characteristic polynomial. So now you compare the coefficient of x n minus 1, right? X n minus 1 is this one. Okay? And here, if you count, you will get this value. Ks times theta 1. So there you are.
Other questions? Maybe some comments? If you want, then I can add some comments.
Okay.
The recent mission said that they were lacking, and probably sounds premature. But I just meant the organizers of the continents look like a seducing. But now I hope that I just expressed opinion of the whole audience of all participants of the conference that people would like to have and share as a lecture with you. So let us thank you once again.
I also would like to thank the organizers for inviting me. And I also would like to thank two people with whom I constantly contacted, discussing the topic of my lecture, proofs, etc., etc. This is Misha Klin and Ilya Panamarenko. So These two guys were here somewhere, in an invisible way, okay? Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.